Testing. Okay, let's get this started. All right, and we are live. Hello, welcome everybody out there. Ryan Kittleson back in the hot seat, getting some sculpting done today. Thanks everybody who's joined so far. Really excited to get started on this one. So today we're going to do a caricature of a celebrity. And I'm just going to start sculpting. I have my reference images in a different monitor. And the first person to guess who this is wins a free copy of my plugin Ryan's Tools for ZBrush. So look alive, get ready, here we go. Just one little hint on the celebrity. They are not super famous, but they're not really obscure either. They're kind of in between, kind of a rising star. I'm not going to say in what field. Ha. I will also give away that they are alive currently, so it's not Edgar Allan Poe. Sorry, Alex Curry. All right, so I'm just going to start sculpting. We'll just see what happens. And if anybody has questions about ZBrush, questions about what I'm doing, how I'm doing it, feel free to just ask away in the chat. My first live stream in a few weeks. I went away for a few weeks to Philadelphia, New York City, and Boston. A friend of mine was running the Philadelphia Marathon, so I went there to cheer him on. And then we went on to New York City, saw some friends, then back to Boston for Friendsgiving. The classic American tradition of Friendsgiving. I will not give away if they are a movie or TV series, or they might not even be an entertainer. Ooh. Might not. Oops, I didn't want to have Sculptors Pro turned on. Also, I'm going to try to push the caricatureness of this a little bit further than I usually do. Try to do something that's like caricatured but not extreme, but I'm gonna try to go a little bit more extreme with this one, I think. So it's gonna be a challenge. It's gonna be a little different from what I usually do. So I'm gonna try to establish those kind of more extreme proportions right off the bat. What is my prox? I'm not sure what you mean. What is that? Oh, process for deciding how far to push features. That is, it just comes down to feeling, really. When you're doing caricatures, it's just what feels right. No worries, Alex. Well, I'm constantly switching between tools, and I use so many hotkeys, you probably wouldn't be able to tell anyway because I'm just hitting hotkeys to switch. So I'd have to share like a video camera of my keyboard. And I use a lot of custom tools. I use my plugin Ryan's Tools a lot. And so it'd probably be too hard to catch up or keep up with what I'm doing, honestly. And I use so many hotkeys that are custom as well. I don't use the standard hotkeys. And so, unfortunately, I don't think anybody would learn very much by even like sitting and watching me in person, except when it comes to my technique, but you can see that on the screen, so. I'm gonna found there's some reference images I was hoping to find of like facial expressions of this person, and I wasn't able to find them this morning before starting, so I might have to take a peek through Google image search, see if I can find some better ones. Not Jim Carrey. Gonna do a kind of a caricatured, oversized nose here. At least to start, we'll see what this looks like. A little crazy, a little extreme. Yes, I do have a plugin that changes my standard gizmo. I'm going to type into the chat, actually, a link to it. So that link is to my plugin, and if you get the pro version for $20, there is a custom gizmo, which so you can use the exact same gizmo I use here. Trying to find a good picture. Nothing's coming up that's like exactly what I want. Let's go on Shoemaker. Gretien official. You have to go to the ZBrush page for that. There's free trials, there's paid versions, depending on what you're going for. Hopefully you can find what you need on the official ZBrush page. I'm gonna get some hair going. The hair might be a clue. Oh crap, symmetry was on wrong. Yeah, I was not using symmetry on purpose, just to get the ear out, because I was using the move tools, and it's the way ZBrush changed how the symmetry works with the move tool kind of messed with my workflow. But this early on, it's really easy to just slap a weld and merge on that. It does kind of. Just two. I've got two, the head and the hair. The ears are one subtool with the head. So I was mirroring and welding the whole head, but the only part of the head that was asymmetrical was the ear. So that's the only part that you saw change. So the mouth is a little tricky. I know I've seen higher resolution images of this guy before, and his mouth is like kind of distinctive, and I'm just not seeing it in the reference images I have up right now. So I'm gonna try to wing it. Finally figured out the reason why the live stream was putting the wrong name on it every time, is there was a setting I needed to switch, and nobody told me. So, yay, the stream is actually showing the correct name this time. It is not Tony Shalhoub. I don't know who that is, though. Who is Tony Shalhoub? You got it, Mr. Name in Cyrillian that I can't pronounce. So the winner today, I can't remember if I mentioned that, gets a free copy of my plugin, Ryan's Tools, a $20 value, which comes with also not just the plugin, but also my custom gizmo, some cool brushes, some cool materials, other neat things. So if you don't win the competition today, at least you can go get that plug-in yourself, get it for Christmas, get it for a friend, ask someone to give it to you for the holidays. It makes a great stocking stuffer. Yeah, shining armor. That's I mean, I've done hundreds, literally hundreds of likeness sculpts in my life. That's what happens when you practice. Oh, that's crazy. Don't know. I'm trying to decide how crazy big I want to make the ears. That's good right there. It is not King Charles III, nor the second, nor the fourth. So shining armor, my practice routine. I mean, it's a combination of a lot of stuff: work projects, personal projects. Also, back, oh man, 10 years ago, I was doing. It's probably even more than 10 years, maybe. Anyway, roughly 10 years ago, a little bit more. I had a practice of doing a caricature speed sculpt every day for 2 hours, and I was recording them and putting them on YouTube. And you can still see most of them on YouTube now. If you search my name and caricature speed sculpt, you can find what I was doing on YouTube. And I've come a long way. That was kind of like some of my earliest work with caricature and likeness. So a lot of them are not as good as what I would do now, but it's fun. It's good stuff. That was really good for getting my skills up. Just having a daily practice where, it doesn't matter how I'm feeling that day, I just sit down for 2 hours and sculpt a caricature. I haven't done it in a while, but I think, if anybody wants to get good at sculpting, doing portraits, doing likeness, I think some sort of exercise like that is like really, really good, really beneficial. It's just like going for the gym, but for your sculpting brain. I'm going to try to get his mouth in. Just wish I had some better pictures of it. Hey Libra, glad you could join us from Belgium. I actually went to Belgium once about 10 years ago. They're really nice to Brussels. What part of Belgium are you from? Hey Rosvan, well, greetings. Glad you could make it from Austria. I hadn't heard of that town on the coast of Belgium, although I was barely in Belgium for a couple days, so didn't get to see very much. Did enjoy the beer though. You guys do make very good beer. Yeah, that mouth's going to take a lot of work before it's ready for prime time. It is not Emmanuel Macron. Yeah, Belgian chocolate. That's good stuff. It is not Biden. So Libra, I guess you're joining us late. It's a competition to see who can guess first who this is. And the winner gets a copy of my plugin Ryan's Tools. They have $20 value. Maybe that'll help. That is right. You have to guess to win. Oh, by the way, I'm drinking out of a mug that I made in my ceramic studio. It's good to sculpt in real life, too. You guys, I'm not super happy with this mouth, but I'm going to move on to the eyes. After I do a couple little touch-ups. It is not Richard Nixon. It's not Obama. Come on. Jimmy Wardlaw? I don't know who that is. It is not Mr. Bean, but that is close, actually. I definitely see some similarities with this guy and Mr. Bean. You did Google image reverse search on it. I would say that's cheating, but that's pretty clever. I'm just gonna save this really quick because you never know when it's gonna crash. Right, the eyes are okay enough for right now, so let's go back to the mouth. I think I found a better picture of his smile anyway. Hey there, Puya Acoustic Man. Hey, Shining Armor. Yeah, I have worked a bit in games and films. I worked on Wendell and Wild, which is on Netflix, made by the director of Nightmare Before Christmas. Not a lot in games, though. Why? What's your question? It is not Roger Federer. Do you model the mouth open for animation or closed? It depends a lot on different factors. For example, it could just come down to the preferences of the rigger who's going to work on it. It could come down to the design of the character, like what's better for that. Yeah, it just really depends. Sometimes mouth open is easier, or at least open just a little bit, just enough so that there's no overlap between the upper lips and lower lips. Nope, it is not Jim Carrey. It is not George Bush, unfortunately, Srecha Banapanan. If I get this caricature to a point where I feel like it's really a good example of who it is I'm sculpting, I'll start giving more hints. But right now, yeah, I wouldn't blame anybody for not getting it. Glad you're enjoying it, Sriracha. It is not Ichabod Crane. It is a real person. Also, a real person who is alive. Going through the hints right now. The hints that I have given out. Real person who is alive is not super famous, but also isn't really obscure either. Kind of like in between super famous and obscure. It's not Jimmy Stewart. Is not Treat Williams. Good guesses, though. Not Prince Charles. Is not David Letterman. See, I think there's a new way to mask by creased edges. Where is that? There we go, mask by crease. Thanks, Kat. Hey, Jera. Yeah, this is a gizmo that I made myself. It's part of my plugin, Ryan's Tools. And yeah, Ryan's Tools is the plugin I'm giving away for free, actually, for the first person who guesses who this is a caricature of. So get your guesses in. Oh, wow, somehow I made that asymmetrical. Okay, I think I can just do a quick mirror and weld. Yeah, that fixed it. It is not Jimmy Carr. Nope, not Jimmy Fallon. Joanna asks, what do I recommend for improving eye and impression sculpting? Just practice, practice, practice. There's no substitute for work if you want to get good at this stuff. It is not Clive Owen. That's a good guess, though. I could see the resemblance. Let's try to put a little bit of sculpted detail in the hair. Maybe that'll clue things up. Give more hints when I feel like it's actually like really looking like him. Right now, I don't quite feel like I've got him looking quite right yet. It's not JFK Jr. That is a good guess, Eugene Levy, but it is not correct. Nope, not Robert De Niro. Zachary Quinto is a good guess, but it is not. It is not Robert Kennedy. Andrew Garfield, nope. Not Adam Driver, that's a good guess though. Is not a young Jon Stewart. Sometimes with caricature, you might push something a little too far, and I realize you got to take it back. And I'm kind of like debating with myself whether I've done that or not. But that's what it's all about. You never get it right first time, really. It's always something to play with and kind of figure it out. There's always backtracking. Not Eugene Levy. Nope, not Elliot Gould. No, not John Mulaney. Can't believe nobody has guessed the person that I think I actually kind of made him most like, but is not correct. All right, I'm going to do something really quick that will make it look more like the person that I think it looks like rather than who it actually looks like. And props to the person who can guess first. Anybody get that? No, not Ben Affleck. Can't believe nobody guessed Michael Richards, aka Kramer. Is not Ben Affleck or Chris Isaac. You know, I gotta make the mouth wider. There's one thing I didn't get correct on this. I think that was the right move. I'm still not like super happy with it. Not John Travolta. Kind of biffed the anatomy of the jaw where it meets the ear. Needs to come forward. In 1987, Bush. Thought maybe the hair and the eyebrows would be enough to tip people off, but I guess not. Not Steve Guttenberg. Guttenberg is not Jerry Seinfeld. That's how I feel. That I like I don't know many famous people. I just turned 45 and yeah, seeing the when people name who's currently famous, I just never heard, I've even heard of them. It's a weird feeling. Oh no, it is not George Bush. Is not John Stamos, Humphrey Bogart, or Andy Samberg. Those are all good guesses. It is not Alan Thicke or Lee Pace. Is that Pete Sampras? It is not Michael Richards. That's who I was thinking people might guess it was. Not Barack Obama. Hate it when I don't remember which subtool I'm on and I go make some intricate mask, and it's only after I complete the mask I realize that I had the wrong subtool on. Not Ben Stiller. Good guess, though. Liza Minnelli. Nope. I don't think I've ever tried to put enable control painting in a custom UI. Why is it not working? Yeah, I feel like this guy is like someone that a lot of people have probably seen, but like didn't really hear the name or remember his name. Not John Stamos. As much as I really like to like caricature ears where they have kind of like the stylized kind of like almost squared off shape, this guy's ears are really not doing that, and I think that might be hurting the likeness. It is not Sarkozy, nor is it Jeff Goldblum. Those are good guesses, though. That's funny, Srivastava. Yeah, there's a lot of menu buttons that are like really big, and when I put them in a custom UI, they just take up so much room. So what I'll do oftentimes is I'll make a macro, and the macro does nothing but just call that very same button, but then I can make it as a small button and put it in my UI so it doesn't take up a lot of room. No, not Steve Carell, nor Alexander Siddig. Well, we're about running out of time for today. I'll finish this guy off next week. I've got another slot next Thursday, same time. So feel free to join. Actually, please join next week. And I might even work on this guy between broadcasts to try to get the likeness looking a little bit more like him. So I don't blame you guys at all for not getting him. There's something about the way I sculpted this, it isn't quite coming together. So stay tuned. Stick around. Come on back next week. We'll finish this guy off. Hopefully somebody will win a prize. Take some screenshots right now, if you want to do a little research on your private time, try to figure this one out. That's all right too. But yeah, the first person with the correct answer will win a copy of Ryan's Tools. So, hope everybody has a great week, and we'll see you next time. Thanks for joining.